Right then, for today's video, we're going to take a look at some of our important area formulas. So once we've had a quick recap of these formulas, we're actually going to take a look at some exam-style problem-solving questions. So if you want to have a look through at some of the questions we're going to be covering today, then I've put some timestamps in for each question, so feel free to have a quick look at those. So just as a little recap, we're going to have a look at our important area formulas. So for our first shape we're looking at, we've got our square. So when we've got our square, we've got our base here, and we've got our height here. So because this is a square, we know the sides are all going to be the same. The base dimension would also be identical to the height dimension. So the area for our square would just simply be base multiplied by height. Okay, we're going to have the same for our rectangle. We know we have the base of the rectangle here. We have our height. So then to find the area of the rectangle, all we have to do is multiply these sides together. So this would also be base multiplied by height. Okay, our next shape we've got is a parallelogram. So to find the area of a parallelogram, what we have to do is the base of the shape, which is this side here. We then have to multiply this by its vertical or perpendicular height, which is actually the distance from the top of the shape all the way down to the bottom of the shape. So it's not actually the length of these sides here, it's the vertical height from top to bottom. So again, our area for a parallelogram is also base multiplied by height. Okay, now moving on to find the area of a triangle, we need to take the base, and just like the parallelogram, we now need to multiply it by its vertical height, so this length h. But then once we've done that, for our triangles, we have to divide this by 2. So our formula for the area of a triangle is just base multiplied by height, which we then divide by 2. And then for the final area formula we're going to look at is the area of a trapezium. So to find the area of a trapezium, we're going to label its two parallel sides A and B. So we can see the two parallel sides would actually be this one and this one. Meaning if they continued on forever, they wouldn't touch. It wouldn't be these two sides because we can see how these lines are sloped and would end up crossing over each other. So I'm going to label this top side A and this bottom side B. To find the area, we also need the vertical or perpendicular height. And we'll label that H. So then the formula for the area of a trapezium is actually a half of whatever the sum of A plus B is, which then we multiply by the height. So that was just a quick recap on some of our important area formulas. As I said, we're now going to take a look at some exam-style problem-solving questions. Okay, for this first question, we've got find the area of the trapezium. So we're going to go back to my formulas. The formula for the area of a trapezium was a half of whatever the sum of A plus B is, then I multiply that by my perpendicular height. So let's find these sides. A and B are going to be the lengths of the two parallel sides, which we can see in this question would be this top length here of 3 and this bottom length here of 7. So those would be our values for A and B. And then we need to multiply by this perpendicular height, H, which is our 5. So all I need to do is substitute this into the formula. I've got a half of 3 plus 7, which then I'm going to multiply by 5. So simplifying further, we've got a half inside the bracket. We've got 3 plus 7, which is 10, which I'm still going to multiply by 5. So we've got a half of 10, which is 5, which then we have to multiply by 5, which finally gives us 25. So for my answer, I need to make sure I'm using the correct units. Because we were using centimetres and we've now found the area, our units for this question would be 25 centimetres squared. And that would be the answer to that question. Okay, this time we've got the area of the square is 100 centimetres squared. Find the perimeter of the square. So this time we've actually been given the area of the shape. We need to work our way backwards and find the dimensions of the square. So it tells us the area of the square is 100 centimetres squared. So we know the area of a square, we simply just do base multiplied by height. But because it's a square, we know these two dimensions are the same. We know that the base is the same as the height. So because I know base and height are the same, instead of writing base times height, this is exactly the same as saying base multiplied by the base. And we know this is going to give us the area, which we are told is 100. Well, if we do b times b, we get b squared. It's still equal to 100. Then if we know what b squared is, all we have to do to find what this b is the square root. So if we do the square root of 100, we get 10. So we know that the base side is 10, which is the same as the height. Because it's a square, we know that all the sides are going to be 10 centimetres. So if we just label that on the diagram now, we know that all of these sides are going to be 10 centimetres long. That's extremely useful because the question actually was find the perimeter of the square. So all we need to do now to find the perimeter is add all these sides together. So we've got 10 add 10 add 10 add 10 is simply going to be 40. And then our units are going to be centimetres as we're looking for the total length. Okay, for our next question, we've got the area of a trapezium is 60 metres squared. Find the length of h. So looking at the diagram, we can see we're looking for the vertical length. So going back to the formula for our trapezium, we've got the area of a trapezium is a half of a plus b, then multiplied by h. So now we can start substituting in. So we've got a half of, well, we know a and b are going to be 3 and 7. So I'm going to put 3 for a plus 7 for b. And then we're multiplying by h. So simplifying further, we've got a half of 3 plus 7 is 10, which then we're multiplying by h. So then if we do a half multiplied by 10, we've got 5, then multiplied by h. So we've got an expression for the area of the trapezium, which is 5h. But we also know that the area is 60. So we can make an equation that 5h is equal to 60. So if I know that 5h is equal to 60, all I need to do now to find h is divide both sides by 5. So if I divide 60 by 5, that should give me 12. So that means the height of the trapezium would be 12, then using the correct units would be meters, because we're just looking for the length. Okay, and for our final question today, we've got below is a right angle triangle and a parallelogram. The area of the parallelogram is 5 times the area of the triangle. Find the height of the parallelogram labelled h. Okay, so this is just like the question before. We're looking for a missing side, which means we would have to been given the area beforehand. So because we need the area, we need to use this triangle, because we know that the area of the parallelogram is 5 times the area of the triangle. So that's what we're going to do first. We're going to look for the area of the triangle. So for our formula for the area of a triangle, we've just got to do base multiplied by our height, which then we divide by 2. So that would just simply be our base, which is 3, which we multiply by 8, which we then divide by 2. So we'd have 3 times 8, which is 24, which then when we divide by 2 would just give us 12. So we know that the area of our triangle is 12 centimetres squared. So now going to the question, if it says the area of the parallelogram is 5 times the area of the triangle, all we now have to do is 12 multiplied by 5, which is 60. And that would give us the area of the parallelogram. So the area of this would be 60 centimetres squared. So now that we've got the area of the parallelogram, we can work our way backwards. So we know for the area of a parallelogram, we have to do the base times its vertical height. So for our example here, the base is 10, which then we multiply by the height, and that would give us the area, which we already know is 60. So if we divide both sides by 10, we can see that h is actually just going to be 6. So for our final answer, the length of h would be 6 centimetres. And that would be our final answer. Right, that's it for today's video. I hope you found it useful. If you did, please feel free to leave a like and consider subscribing. If there are at all any topics you'd like me to go through next, then please just let me know down in the comments, and I'll try to make some videos on those topics as soon as possible. So thank you very much for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.